Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So how are you all? I hope that you all are doing fine in terms of your health as well as your examination preparation. So this is the first day of a new week, and on this day, let's make a promise to ourselves that we will not cram our minds with a lot of information as well as not burden ourselves too much, because too much of a burden will kill the bull. Okay, and we don't have to kill it right now. So on that note, let's begin our video, which is of course going to be light because it is in line with our resolution that we have taken right now for this week. So let's quickly begin this video. But before that, those who are watching me for the first time, guys, you can subscribe our channel if you like the video and if you learn something new during the video. Also, the information for you here is that you can get the PDF of this session on the Telegram group. Okay. So if you want the PDF, you can join our Telegram group. The link is in description below. So here is our first question about the portal of Ministry of Development. What is the name of the portal developed by Defense Accounts Department for conducting payment and accounting via this platform? So Prabal, Swarnim, Akansha, Mudra, Shobha are in the options, out of which Prabal, option A, is the right answer, guys. So as the question itself is telling us that it is for managing or conducting the accounting and payment transactions of the Ministry of Defense. So that is the whole purpose behind launching this Prabal portal. Okay. Now the Defense Accounts Department of this portal of the Ministry of Defense has launched this IT enabled payment accounting system, which is named as Prabal. Okay, so this is the entire system of information technology wherein all the accounting and the financial transactions will be managed, and those transactions pertain to the Ministry of Defense. Okay, so that is all. There is nothing much in this news. Moving on to the next question. What is India's GDP forecast for 2021 to 2022 by World Bank? So this forecast was provided by the World Bank in its South Asia Economic Focus report. Of course, we will be delving into that report, but let's first have a look at the forecast given by World Bank for India for the current year. So current year, the forecast is 8.3%. Now guys, the very first thing that you should look upon is the title of this report: Shifting Gears, Digitization and Service-Led Development. So this report was more focused on digitization in South Asia and services-led development in the South Asian region. Now India's GDP forecast is 8.3% for the current year and 7.5% for the next year. And this increase in the GDP forecast, or we can say this high GDP forecast, is because India is witnessing an increase in public investment and in the incentives to boost manufacturing. Okay, public investment means the investment done by the government and the incentives that the government of India is giving to the manufacturing. And we have a very living example of the incentives given to the manufacturing units in the form of PLI schemes, production linked incentive schemes, that was made or launched in order to boost manufacturing in India only. Can you guys tell me that what is the manufacturing target of India? So do mention it in the comment section below. And this is the table, forecast table for the entire South Asian region. Here you can see for the South Asian region, the GDP forecast is 7.1%, 7.1% and 5.4%. Guys, this is 2021 to 2022. This is 2022 to 2023. This is 23 to 24. Okay. So this is the GDP forecast for the entire South Asian region. Here you can see India's GDP forecast. Now in the current year, 8.3%, in next year, 7.5%, and in the year 2023 to 2024, India's GDP forecast would be 6.5%. Now, if you want to make comparison, then you can compare India's GDP with Bangladesh, and you don't have to look at the other country's GDP forecast. Okay, so this is the consolidated table that I found in the report, therefore I have put it here. But you don't have to cram yourself with a lot of information. You just have to put your attention on the most important part. That is the South Asian region's GDP forecast, India's GDP forecast, most prominently, and from the comparison point of view, because at present in the South Asian region, only Bangladesh is competent enough to give a competition to India, okay, which you can see here also. In the year 2023 to 2024, Bangladesh will supersede India in terms of GDP. Okay, so here the Bangladesh GDP forecast is 6.9% in comparison to India's GDP forecast when the things will turn normal for this country, because right now we are under the impact of coronavirus pandemic. Okay, that's why the GDP forecast varies this much. On the one hand, we have negative 7.3, and on the other hand, we have positive 8.3% GDP forecast. Okay, but when the things will turn normal, you can see in the South Asian region, Bangladesh is going to give us a very strict competition, we can say. Okay, so you can just keep this thing in your mind. Who among the following has won UNHCR Nansen Refugee Award 2021? So here you can see many organizations in the options. Let me first tell you that this award is given, as the name itself is suggesting. So this award is given for the, basically this award is given to humans, individuals and organizations for helping refugees. Okay. Now this year, Jil Albena Association for Humanitarian Development, which is an NGO in Yemen, so it has got this award for providing humanitarian assistance to the refugees in Yemen. So here you can see that it provided assistance to the internally displaced people in the northern Yemen region. That's why it got this award. Now this award was instituted in 1954 to honor individuals, groups or organizations who go beyond to help the people who are in need, the people who are refugees. Okay, now this organization was founded by Amin Jubran. Do remember the name of this person, Amin Jubran. Now guys, here you need to know that this award was given region wise as well. Okay, so this organization is the overall winner of this award, but regionally also there were winners of this award. Now you had a winner from the European region, you had a winner from African region, from America as well. So here what I think Asia's winner is most important, that's why I have put it here only. Okay, so only Asia's winner is there. Salima Rehman, who is a gynecologist in Pakistan, she has got this award from the Asian region, from entire Asia. Okay, moving on to the Nobels. So in which category has David W.C. Macmillan won Nobel Prize 2021? Chemistry, physics, medicine, economics, peace. The right answer is chemistry. So he has got this award in the field of chemistry. Not only him, Benjamin List is also accompanying him. Now Benjamin List belongs to Germany, David Macmillan belongs to UK. Do remember their nationalities. Both of them have got this award, Nobel Prize, for their work on building molecules that are mirror images of one another. Next is again from Nobel. So who has won the Nobel Prize in Literature? This time it has been won by a Tanzanian writer, Abdul Razak Gurna. Okay, so he is a Tanzanian writer, and he has got the Nobel Prize in Literature. Guys, here it's a misprinting, or we can say mistyping. Tanzania was to be here. So don't worry, when you will get the PDF, you will get the rectified PDF. Okay, so don't worry about this mistake, but do pay attention to what I'm saying right now. His nationality is Tanzanian, but at present he is living in UK and he writes in English. So he's an English author. Now he has written over 10 novels and several short stories. He's the fifth African writer to win the Nobel Prize for Literature after Nigerian writer Wall Soyinka, Egyptian writer, South African writer, and you have other writers as well. Okay, so all of these have won the award in the field of literature in the past, and Gunna has become the fifth writer from the African region to win the Nobel Prize in Literature. So that is all that you need to know about him. Who among the following has won the 2021 Global Leadership Humanitarian Award? Julie Sweat, Arvind Krishna, Brad Smith, only A and B, only A, B and C. So here the right answer is option E, only A, B and C. So all of these three people have got this award. Now, first of all, you need to know that US-India Business Council gives this award. This council only gives a very prominent award, which is known as Global Leadership Award. And this year, this award has been given to Shiv Nadar and Mallika Srinivasan. So my question from you guys is, okay, Srinivasan. My question from you is that both of these belong to which companies? They are holding very prominent positions in their respective companies. You have to tell me their positions as well as their companies. Okay, so this year, these two people have got the Global Leadership Award, which is given to the top leaders, top managers in the companies in US or India, in US companies or Indian companies, who work towards improving the economy of US and India, as well as bilateral relations between both the countries. Okay, so this year this award has been given to both of these. Now, if we discuss about the Global Leadership Humanitarian Award, then as the name itself is indicating, that this award is different from the Global Leadership Award. This is given for humanitarian purpose to the leaders, to the managers of the companies who have shown some great contribution towards humanitarian cause, as these three leaders have done so. Okay, so these three leaders have basically coordinated and created the Global Task Force on Pandemic Response when India was suffering from the second wave of coronavirus, that is in the month of May. So this was created at that point of time to provide relief measures in India. Okay, so that is why these three people have got this award from US India Business Council. Now, Julie Sweat is the CEO and chairperson of Accenture. Arvind Krishna is the chairperson and CEO of IBM. Brad Smith is the president and vice chair of Microsoft. So do remember their companies and their designations as well. Okay. Next question is, who has won the FIH Rising Star of the Year 2021 award? So basically, FIH is the Federation of International Hockey, and where is the headquarters of it? That you have to tell me in the comment section. Now, coming back to this question, so recently these awards have been announced, and you would be amazed that in all the categories, the toppers are Indians. So this is a very proud moment for all of us. Now, in the Rising Star of the Year award category, Sharmila Devi has won this award. Guys, the people you are seeing in the list, all of them have won the FIH Hockey Star Awards, but in different categories. So now let's have a look at them. So here you can see Player of the Award has been given to Harmanpreet Singh and Gurjeet Kaur, both in men and women categories respectively. Goalkeeper of the award in men's, P.R. Srijesh, in women's, Savita Punya. Rising Star of the Year award, Vivek Sagar Prasad and Sharmila Devi. The Best Coach award, Graham Reid, India's hockey team coach, and Stuart Marine, who is also India's hockey team coach for the women's hockey team. Okay, now the hockey men's team captain is Manpreet Singh. And Indian women's hockey team's captain is Rani Rampal. Do remember the captains as well. And the list of awardees is right in front of you that you have to memorize from your exam point of view. But this is such a great thing that all the categories in both the genders, men and women, are occupied by the Indians only. So on that happy note, I'm going to say goodbye to you all. Prepare hard for your examination, and if you have learned something new during the video, then do not forget to share this video, like this video, and subscribe our channel. Thank you.